So burst early for Christmas. As the curtain rises, we see the assistant. She says, she's talking to herself. She says, "My, what a busy day it was for me yesterday. Oh, yesterday was a very busy day for me because this is Christmas season. I didn't have a minute's rest all day. Throughout the day, 24 hours, I have been working. What with Christmas nearly here and people sending parcels and cards. So Christmas is very near, maybe one or two days more, and then there will be Christmas. People are sending cards. Now, of course, these days nobody will send cards. It's all online now. Everything is online. So no parcel, nothing of that sort. Everything is done online. Parcels you cannot do, but cards and greetings and so on, they are doing online. Rest all day and parcels and cards. What funny people there are in this world. She's a very interesting lady, very friendly, very polite. So she says, lot of people come here, they misunderstand. One of them, immediately you can see what she says. Funny people there are in this world. What funny people there are in this world, to be sure. Only the other day, a man came to my post office and said, "Please, could you tell me where I could get a stamp?" Coming to the post office, that man is asking, "Could you please tell me where I can get a stamp?" Post office vandha chodikkana, "Evidiyana enikku post or stamp vaangikkana, evidunnaa enikku stamp kittunnu." You know, they're funny chodyangalaanu. So that's why she says, these people are many funny people in this world. Then, he said, and continues, she says, "Please, could you tell me where I could get a stamp? "Of course." At first I thought he was playing a joke on me. Then there was the old man who couldn't see very, very well. He put his glass on the counter and said, "A pint of beer, please, miss." There was an old man came. One gentleman came to the post office and asks the assistant, "Where can I get a stamp?" First she thought that he's playing a joke on her. Anyway, she did not get angry with him. She served him. Then another person comes. He can't see much. He is suffering from cataract or some other problem. His glass may not be working properly. Glass means his spectacles. So he put his glass on the counter and said, "A pint of beer, please." Post office, a pint of beer. Pint in the morning, we are going to a beer. Post office. And that's why the assistant says, people are very funny here around. "So, a beer please, miss." So I gave him a dozen penny stamps. So what did I do? A penny stamp means a stamp for very small amount. Say for example, 1 paisa, 2 paisa, etc. We said, they're costing very small amount. 1 dozen penny stamps. Instead of this, I gave 1 dozen penny stamps. She opens a book. And then what happens is, he put his answer. And she opens a book of stamps. "Oh, here is my first customer." So she shows us a book of stamps and says, "I gave the old gentleman who came here, who couldn't see properly, asking for a pint of beer. I gave, look at this. This is the book of stamps." Then, after saying like this, about the last day's work, she says, "Very busy, it is Christmas season, many people are coming, and some of them are very funny. One of them came here and said, please, where can I get a stamp? Another person came here and said, let me have a pint of beer and things like that. And then she said, I gave him a dozen penny stamps. A dozen penny stamps means stamps costing, like we say, paisa now, one paisa. So one penny means very small, the coin, the value of the coin is very, very small. So such stamps I gave him. That's what she says. Theeda vela koranya oru oru dozen stamp enavan kodutu ane avane paranju vittu. See, idu kanalo, she opens a book of stamps. Oh, here is my first customer, and Mrs. Smith and this. So first customer of this day is Mrs. Smith. Mrs. Smith, good morning, Miss Cole, isn't it? So this is, in this, you know, when you are reading this play, you find how people are, they're using colloquial language, means samsara bhasha, colloquial language. Well, and then their greetings, Englishman, എങ്ങനെയാണ് ബിഹേവ് ചെയ്യുന്നത്, ഇങ്ങനെയുള്ള കാര്യങ്ങളൊക്കെ നമുക്ക് ഇതിനകത്ത് മനസ്സിലാക്കാം. സോ ഈസ് ഇറ്റ് മിസ്സസ് സ്മിത്ത്? മിസ്സസ് സ്മിത്ത് സേസ്, ഗുഡ് മോർണിംഗ് മിസ് കോൾ, ഇസ്ന്റ് ഇറ്റ്? ദെൻ അസിസ്റ്റന്റ് സേസ്, യെസ്, സർട്ടൻലി ഈസ്. ഇറ്റ് ലുക്സ് ആസ് ദോ വി ഷാൽ ബി ഹാവിംഗ് സ്നോ ഫോർ ക്രിസ്മസ്. സോ അസിസ്റ്റന്റ് സേസ്, ദേർസ് എ ചാൻസ് ദാറ്റ് ദേർ മേ ബി സ്നോ ഫോർ ക്രിസ്മസ്. നമ്മൾ പറയുന്നത് മഞ്ഞുകാലമാണ്, അതുകൊണ്ട് മിക്കവാറും കട്ടിയിൽ ഇങ്ങനെ ഐസ് വീഴാൻ സാധ്യതയുണ്ട്. ഐസ് അവിടെ എല്ലാം ഐസ് കൊണ്ട് നിറയാനുള്ള ഒരു സാധ്യതയുണ്ട്. ക്രിസ്മസ് ആകുമ്പോൾ നിങ്ങൾ ഒരു പക്ഷേ കണ്ടു കാണുമല്ലോ ഈ പടങ്ങളിലൊക്കെ, ഈ വെസ്റ്റേൺ കൺട്രീസിലൊക്കെ ഇങ്ങനെ വഴി നിറങ്ങി ഇങ്ങനെ ഐസ് കിടക്കുന്നതാണ്, അല്ലെ, ഐസ് കട്ടകളിലൂടെ ഇങ്ങനെ മൂടിക്കിടക്കുന്നതാണ്. സോ ദാറ്റ്സ് വാട്ട് ഷീ സേസ്, ദേർ ഇസ് എ ചാൻസ് ദാറ്റ് വി ആർ ഗോയിങ് ടു ഹാവ് എ സ്നോ ദിസ് Christmas season. Mrs. Smith, I hope don't. Snow is bad for my rheumatism. I said, oh, I think I wish that there won't be snow because I am suffering from rheumatism. I'm a rheumatic patient. I have rheumatism, you know. Last Christmas I had it so badly that I couldn't enjoy myself at all. So if snow, that means it's a suffering for me. Snow veena enna manju veena allengil ice veena thodumbaanengil alle ice kondu ivada ella nalayuvaanengil endu sambhavikkum? Then I am suffering from rheumatism. Njan vaada rogiya appo adukondu enik bayangara vishamaya vedanikkundo. Last year it was like that, and therefore I could enjoy myself for Christmas, during Christmas season. That's what she says. I hope it won't happen. Assistant, let's hope it doesn't snow. Then, what can I do for you, Mrs. Smith? So, let's hope. So, you can see now, she is also joining. She is also expressing the same feeling of her customer. And then she is asking, what can I do for you? Can I help you in any way? And then, Mrs. Smith, a book of stamps, please. And a postal order for half a crown. That's what she says. I came here for buying a book of stamps and a postal order. A postal order is one way of sending money to another person. Postal order. We say money order, no? So like that, this is a postal order. You buy and send it, and the person who receives it can encash it. Postal order, നമ്മളോട് പൈസ കൊടുത്തിട്ട് ഒരു പോസ്റ്റൽ ഓർഡർ വാങ്ങിക്കുക, എന്നിട്ട് അത് നമ്മുടെ ഫ്രണ്ടിനോ ആർക്കെങ്കിലും അയച്ചു കൊടുക്കുക, അയാൾക്ക് അത് അവിടെ ക്യാഷ് ആക്കാൻ പറ്റും. ഇപ്പോൾ ഈ പോസ്റ്റൽ ഓർഡർ ഉണ്ടോ എനിക്ക് സംശയം, എനിക്ക് തോന്നുന്നില്ല. പോസ്റ്റൽ ഓർഡറിൻ്റെയൊക്കെ കാലം കഴിഞ്ഞു തോന്നും, അല്ലേ? ഈവൻ ഫോർ മണി ഓർഡർ പീപ്പിൾ ആർ നോട്ട് ട്രാൻസ്ഫറിങ് മണി. യുവർട്ട് പേടിഎം, യുവർട്ട് ഇൻ്റർനെറ്റ് ബാങ്കിങ് ആൻഡ് സോൺ. സോ ഐ ഡോണ്ട് തിങ്ക് ഇറ്റ് ഹാസ് ഗോട്ട് എനി റിലവൻസ് ദീസ് ഡേയ്സ് നൗ. ഓക്കെ, ഐ ഹോപ്പ് ഡോണ്ട് സോ എക്സെട്ര. ആൻഡ് അസിസ്റ്റൻസ് ഈസ് let's hope she agrees with you, with her. And Mrs. Smith said, a book of stamps please, and a postal order for half a crown. Half a crown is the value of the postal order. Assistant, no parcel for me to weigh? Haven't you got any parcel for me to weigh? And then Mrs. Smith said, Then she says, Mrs. Smith says that, good gracious, good gracious. It's a way of expressing some kind of sympathy or love or affection towards the person to whom, with whom you are conversing. Or a feeling with her or with him. Oh, good gracious, he says. Now, good gracious, no. I have sent all my parcels, my presents and cards. I have already sent. I believe in posting early for Christmas. So the first customer is one who actually in no way troubles, who actually does not want to trouble anybody. The assistant also says, Yanga Kyatam Nairade Aichuri. Nikari and last minute to everybody. So I have already sent it. No problem. No problem. I am happy and you are also happy. Then what happens is that the assistant says, I wish more people would do that. It's no wonder parcels are damaged on the last minute. Last minute rush, says. So the assistant says, last minute rush. December 24th, naturally, what will happen? There is a chance that it may get damaged. Rush, haste makes waste in the proverb. Last minute, the land is packing. I wish more people would do that. Mrs. Smith, post early for Christmas. Rush. Last minute rush could be avoided. There you are, Mrs. Smith, your stamp and your postal order. One first customer was friendly at some side, you know. And Mrs. Smith was assistant agreed in the customer. Post office visit the assistant wants that should post early for Christmas. And Smith, Mrs. Smith does that. And she wants to buy some stamps and a book of stamps and a postal order, and that she gives. So that engagement is over. The business relationship over there. Then another character comes in. Another funny people. Another of these blundering idiots. Blundering idiots. Blundering idiots. Blundering idiots. Yesterday we have already seen, and that is the tourists. Yes, and then what happens is another character, another person visits, and that is Mrs. Jones. And Mrs. Jones, he says, good gracious. I hope I don't snore, etc. And then she says, no parcel for me, no good gracious, etc. And that's all. I wish more people would be like this, and the postal order, etc. Oh. And now comes Mrs. Jones and this. Mrs. Smith, thank you. Thank you. And I says, hello, Mrs. Jones. How are you? I haven't seen you for a long time. Are you keeping well? But Mrs. Smith Adim, she's thanking the assistant for giving her the book of stamps and the postal for the value of half a crown. And then she turns to Mrs. Jones. It seems that they knew they are friendly, or they are Mrs. Smith's, Mrs. Jones is the friend of Mrs. Smith. കൂട്ടുകാരോ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ അയൽക്കാരോ അല്ലെ ആയിരുന്നിരിക്കണം, അല്ലെ ക്ലബ് മെമ്പേഴ്സ് ആയിരുന്നിരിക്കണം. അപ്പം അവർ ചോദിക്കുകയാണ്, സിൻസ് ഇറ്റ്സ് നോട്ട് ഇറ്റ്സ് വെരി ലോങ് ടൈം സിൻസ് ഐ സിൻസ് ഐ സോ യു സിൻസ് ഐ സോ യു ഇറ്റ്സ് വെരി ലോങ് ടൈം ആൻഡ് ഹൗ ആർ യു നൗ, ആർ യു ഓൾറൈറ്റ്, കീപ്പിംഗ് ഫൈൻ എക്സെട്ര, ഷീ ഈസ് ആസ്കിംഗ്. ദാറ്റ്സ് എ വേ ഓഫ് യു നോ സോഷ്യലൈസിംഗ്. ദാറ്റ്സ് ഷീ സേസ് I am very well, Mrs. Jones, I am very well. Thank you. And have you finished your Christmas shopping yet? I am still in the middle of mine. Well, she says, thank you. You wanted to know how am I going? How are you? Instead of that, you say, how are you? Yes, I am very well. How do you do? These are things, polite inquiries about a person's well-being or a person's health or a person's situation and so on. No? That is, so she's asking, how are you? Are you alright? It has been very long since we met. And she says, she replies, I am very well, I am okay. Thank you very much, she says. And then after she continues, see, I am halfway through my Christmas shopping. What about you? Christmas shopping means, you know, isn't it? You have to buy new clothes, you have to buy lot of things to eat. That's the most important thing, isn't it? Yes, chicken and things like that. So she, have you finished your Christmas shopping? I am still in the middle of mine. In the middle of mine means, I am half pani kazhinju. Pagudhi shopping nadathi, nee pagudhiyum kadakkunnu. Mrs. Smith. He said, I have posted my cards and presents. No problem. I am perfectly all right. It means I am very regular in that sense, he says. I have done everything on time. Mrs. Jones hands some large parcel to the assistant who weighs them. So this is the difference between Mrs. Smith and Mrs. Jones. Mrs. Smith says, I have done everything. So Jones now last minute rush. Some large parcels, not one or two, it seems many. Some large parcel to assistant who weighs them. Then Mrs. Jones, you are lucky. I don't want, you are lucky. That is, she is turning to Mrs. Smith and says this. You are lucky. You are lucky means what? You are lucky that you have finished your shopping. You are lucky that you have done all the work related to Christmas. സോ ഓ നീയൊരു ഭാഗ്യവതിയാണ്, എൻ്റെ വർക്കെല്ലാം കഴിഞ്ഞുള്ളൂ, ഞങ്ങൾ കാര്യമായിട്ടൊന്നും ചെയ്യാനുള്ളൂ, എൻ്റെ ഇനിയും പകുതി കിടക്കുന്നു, പ്ലസ് ഐ ഹാവ് ടു ബുക്ക് ദീസ് പാഴ്സൽസ്. യെസ് യു ആർ ലക്കി. ഐ ഡോണ്ട് വാണ്ട് ദീസ് പാഴ്സൽസ് ഡാമേജ് മിസ് സോ പ്ലീസ് സീ ദാറ്റ് ദി ആർ ഹാൻഡിൽഡ് വെരി കെയർഫുൾ. ആൻഡ് നൗ ദിസ് ടേണിംഗ് ടു ദ അസിസ്റ്റൻറ്റ്, പ്ലീസ് ഐ ഡോണ്ട് വാണ്ട് ദറ്റ് മൈ പാഴ്സൽസ് ഗെറ്റ് ഡാമേജ്, സോ ദെയർഫോർ കൈൻഡ്ലി ടേക്ക് സ്പെഷ്യൽ കെയർ. എപ്പോഴാ ലാസ്റ്റ് മിനിറ്റിൽ സ്പെഷ്യൽ കെയർ, കെയർ വെരി കെയർഫുള്ളി അസിസ്റ്റന്റ്. വെൽ ഐ ഡു അവർ ബെസ്റ്റ്, വിൽ ഡു അവർ ബെസ്റ്റ്, ഓഫ് കോഴ്സ് അവർ ഡിപ്പാർട്ട്മെന്റ് വിൽ ഡു അവർ ബെസ്റ്റ്. വി വിൽ മീൻസ് അവർ ഡിപ്പാർട്ട്മെന്റ് വിൽ ഡു അവർ ബെസ്റ്റ് മാഡം. ഓൾദോ ഇറ്റ് വുഡ് ഹാവ് ബീൻ ബെറ്റർ ഇഫ് ദേ ഹാഡ് ബീൻ പോസ്റ്റഡ് ലാസ്റ്റ് വീക്ക്. അതായിരുന്നു നല്ലത്, ഞങ്ങളെ വിൽ ഡു അവർ ബെസ്റ്റ്. പക്ഷേ കഴിഞ്ഞ ആഴ്ചയിൽ പോസ്റ്റ് ചെയ്തതിന് കുറച്ചുകൂടെ സേഫ് ആയിരുന്നു തന്നെ. ഇറ്റ് വുഡ് ഹാവ് ബീൻ ബെറ്റർ മിസ്സസ് ജോൺസ്. വെൻ ഐ പോസ്റ്റ് മൈ ക്രിസ്മസ് പ്രസൻറ്റ് ഈസ് മൈ ഓൺ അഫെയർ. റൂഡ് വേ ഓഫ് ടോക്കിംഗ്. ഞാൻ എപ്പോഴാണ് എൻ്റെ ക്രിസ്മസ് പ്രസൻറ്റ് അയക്കുന്നത്? എൻ്റെ ഇഷ്ടമാണ്. ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ദാറ്റ് മീൻസ് ഇറ്റ്സ് ഇംപൊലൈറ്റ് ഇറ്റ്, ആൻഡ് ഓൾസോ ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് വെരി റൂഡ്. ഷീസ് എ A very rude lady. That's why she is asking. And then this story and said, I am post to you. She says, please, you could have done it last week, then it would have been good for me as well as for the department and for you. And for your parcel. Your parcel would have remained this, would have reached this safe. See, then since it is last, there is a possibility, but we will try our best. Then she is replying like this, when should I post my parcel? It is my business. none of your business, it is my business, talking very rude. Yes. Then the assistant says politely. She's very polite, very jovial, jovial, sandosham, young lady. So politely, yes, ma'am, that will be 10 and 6 pence. Yes, ma'am, okay. The fee, registration fee would be, if she says 10, that will be 10 and 6 pence. That is the, just as we say now, 10 rupee and 50 paisa, something like that, 10 and 6 pence, it is in their coin, their system. So 10 and 6 pence all together. Then Mrs. Jones hands her the money. So when she says it is 10 and 6 pence all together, means for all these parcels, she gives the money to the assistant. Mrs. Jones joins Mrs. Smith away from the counter. Then Mrs. Smith is maybe standing a bit far, and she goes towards her friend or neighbor or a member of the club. Already she joins. They are becoming, they are coming closer. And in the meanwhile, a deaf old gentleman comes to the assistant. That is the third funny person coming into the post office that morning. So, you know, it's very simple, nothing so deep or profound in the Sambo on the post office, lady assistant. Paradi Varanu, Adi Miranda, Mrs. Smith, Avaka Vendal, a book of stamps and postal order, our Vada Rogian, husband Avaka. Snow was not a good baby. Then another, a rather polite man, another Mrs. Jones. I will say rude no polite no la, but I dissect idea. For a lot of them, Ningle near the parcel I can, another, the end is to the energy in a government. Otherwise, she is friendly with Mrs. Smith. And then she came there last minute. The last minute for booking her parcels or registered post. So like that, booking her parcels. And a third person is coming, that is old, a deaf old gentleman. And then what is he going to do, etc. We will see tomorrow. So now, four of the blundering idiots start the play. First is the assistant. Blundering idiots, see inverted commas, because these are the words of the foreign tourist. Too busy does not get even a minute's rest. According to her, the people are very funny. The assistant. Then first customer is Mrs. Smith. Posted her cards and presents early for Christmas. She has come to buy stamps and a postal order. She is polite and friendly. She suffers from rheumatism and so wishes there won't be snow this season. That is that. She wishes that there won't be snow. Then fourth is Mrs. John, sorry, third is Mrs. John, rude and impolite. Impolite. And then she has come with parcels to be booked at the last minute. And fourth one is a deaf old gentleman, his name is Sam. He comes to collect his old age pension. Old age pension and the interaction between the post, the assistant and the old age man, or deaf old gentleman, we will see tomorrow. Okay? So till then, bye. Have a nice day.